Occasionally just re-grab the swords. I guess you think I know. Oh, not necessarily. You don't necessarily want to grab even if you think they're good. Because you can also lose it in a fight if you're doing it a certain place. And if you swing at the same time, you can just knock the next guy out, so it saves you some more time. And use that right hand to teleport. Switch. Don't throw it too lightly, or else that happens. You have a little time before that person comes, so... but definitely, still want to be ready to turn yourself around. And here, I like to face this way, because tracking. That's not good for me. But up to Black's throws. Remember where the sword went? He's not gonna give me his body. So. The sword's over here. And closer jug here. Weaken bodies. You don't want to swing at the same time as you're swinging, and there's enough time in between. The only thing that matters is the jugger. Got behind you. They're throwing. So, as long as you can reach, you just skip them. And safely take out the left one first. You just don't want to have to worry about the camera being in the way. Thank you. right instead, because that'll spawn some more bad guys. Oh, they aren't close enough. They aren't close enough. There we go. Now it's more efficient if you hit the left. Sometimes you can get them all out in one volley on the left. Oop, see? Face front. And here's a pretty safe place to just shoot people if you want. Don't do much of anything. And here, just run forward. As long as you hit each one, they won't be able to shoot you or do anything. If you miss, it's okay. Duck, come out of the way. And keep going. Definitely take out the top one first, so you don't have to worry about that anymore. That's not good. Definitely want to still keep an eye out on the right just in case he walks out. Let's see. Are we ready to fight? No. I don't know if it's possible to kill everyone that's needed. Huh. Alright. As soon as you hear that sound. Huh. And someone's winding up. Most people are there in it. But if you're new to this area, I like to throw the stick over just in case it's needed over here. Make sure you're facing forward. Throw the stick by main handle. And then duck down over here so the thrower can kill you from over there. And be ready for more to spawn, possibly over here because they're random in the location. See what spawns. Enough away, I don't need to worry about the dagger necessarily. Once you hear him throw, you just move. So aim wherever you are. Sorgrim's time. Save for later. You can get back in your play area if you walk in. You walk out. I do that pretty often. I'm not sure whether the words off. I'm not sure. At least what's considered often. Make sure all of their bounces split already. Like to bring two fresh swords over here, just so it's enough to kill all five bad guys. Don't have to worry about picking up anything else. Just make sure you know where your guns are afterwards. Not guns. Keep your hands up to block. And then you have time. And you can block. Pretty safe to do with swords. You just duck here. If you duck, they'll end up missing you. Sometimes that guy disappears on his own over there, but if he doesn't, go back and shoot him. He disappeared. Move these out of the way. You can possibly grab one of them if you want to just quickly put that down, etc. That can be faster. Or it is faster. If you want to bring the gun with you, which I do like to do for a solo run, just pass by that and opt for bringing the gun. Pick up another box. Swap hands, reload. It's nice to just jump straight across. That helps you. If you're trying to follow other people, etc. You're not good one. Normally, don't pick this up at that point. You can just. As if you're just trying to so that is a safe way to do it. Oh, that's I should switch hands entirely. You don't want this hand that's locking to be. Generally use the this hand to block, the left one. With the fire, with the flame. The other hand we swing. At the bad guys. You can block like that. Okay, thanks for letting me kill two at once. That I did not know. Swordfish, you think, and hill two. And just hear if the music's still going. If it's not, then you did it. And if the music's still going, it's probably a bad guy in one of the walls in the beginning. Here, I like to get close to the bottom portion so that it explodes. If it explodes, then it doesn't explode on you. And it's also that the bottlers, they spawn facing away from you if you're behind them. And when they're not facing you, they don't throw immediately. They'll pause and delay a throw. You'll end up being safe. Just try not to jump in front of one of them, because then that one will throw at you. Yeah, so that's a relatively safe way to do it. But you can also do it with guns. Different preferences. Generally safer to go off to the side over here. You throw it on the edge because sometimes you throw it somewhere where there isn't a solid ground, the gun could be lost forever. This isn't a bad thing. Watch out, because that guy.
Nobody leaves this island with my treasure!
That means we'll see a fight. You have swords ready. Press swords when you can. Know where they are. The note starts right there. And we'll wait for three of them. And we'll go to the hopefully this sword. Oh, all of them are flying away. No. Out, Ghost Reader's back. Figure eight to move. Yay.